Sarah and Leander never spoke of their joint conclusion about the bones and the crystals, out of fear that someone might want to abuse the knowledge. But they were certain that if the crystals would ever return to the bones, the Dragon Lord would revive and bring desolation upon the land once more. Little did they know that the dragon had its faithful servant of the Academy working hard to revive him. However, as the crystals were losing power over the years while they were kept away from their host, they wouldn't be enough to sustain the newly awakened dragon. Their power, which had been dwindling for years, would only make him as powerful as regular. Ever since the Academy of Alchemy was founded, every single headmaster would leave a fragment of his power with the school, in a large crystal beneath its heart. Over time, those fragments turned into the greatest magic core in the world. It would certainly become the magic source the Dragon Lord would need.
How did you get here? Ah, never mind. You should know your place. 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 No! Thank you.
Eliana?
I'm glad everything is over.
The elves opened their gates to the merchants and travelers, and Sarah lifted her curse from the City of Thorns.
I wish Headmaster was here to see it.
I'm sure he would have been proud of you.
I wouldn't have done it without him.